Eric Edberg, the founding artistic director of the Greencastle Summer Music Festival, which has morphed into the Greencastle Virtual Music Festival during the pandemic shutdown. And we are waiting for in-person concerts to resume, hopefully this summer. For now, welcome to my home, and thank you so much for having us into yours. You know, we celebrate community through shared arts experiences and friends making and enjoying music with friends. Staying connected with others is a key component of mental and spiritual health. So keep connected with other people. And one way to do that is every Wednesday night at 7:30 p.m. Eastern Time, we have a watch party and post-concert discussion on Zoom at gvmf.live. So if you're watching somewhere else on a Wednesday evening, please feel free to hop on over at the end of the concert, which is usually about 8:10 or 8:15 p.m. Eastern Time, and join us for that. And if you're not able to join us online, know that it means a lot to have you with us, whether you're watching on cable access TV or Facebook or YouTube, and we really look forward to seeing you in person. We open tonight with Claude Cymerman and me playing our arrangement of Schubert's Rast, or Rest. It's the 10th in Schubert's 24-song journey, Winterreise, or Winter Journey, in this case, of a young man who fell in love and was rejected. So that song was about, only now has he stopped to rest and realizes how tired and sore he is. And in the quiet, he feels for the first time the worm, which stings him inwardly. Later on, we'll be hearing music by Campioni and J.C. Bach, performed by the Vivaldi Project, and also experience a J.S. Bach cello suite movement with an actual baroque dancer. And at the end of the program, a spectacular version of Cool from West Side Story filmed on the streets of New York City. First, though, our Schubertian winter journey continues with Frühlingsstraum, hope I pronounced German somewhat close, or Dream of Spring. He, our lonely protagonist, dreams of springtime and love, but wakes to cold and darkness and the shrieking of ravens. He sees frost leaves painted on the window. When will they turn green? When will he again embrace his beloved?
Thank you.
More Schubert to come later on, but first, here's Elizabeth Field violin, Allison Edberg Nyquist viola, and Stephanie Vial cello, who perform as the Vivaldi Project. They're playing Andante Adagio from the Sonata in G Minor, Opus 1, Number 2, by Carlo Antonio Campioni, who lived from 1720 to 1788, and blended in with the video of them playing is some wonderful Indiana nature photography by Allison's husband, Craig Nyquist. Well, that was delightful. The Vivaldi Project and Craig's photos will be back after two more Schubert songs, as arranged by Claude and me. We're going to hear Einsamkeit, which I probably just mispronounced, or loneliness. He wanders like a sad and lonely cloud through the bright and happy life around him. Even when storms were raging, he says, I was not so miserable. And depost, or the post, he hears a post horn. You know, back in the old days, a horn sounded when the mail came. Why does my heart leap so? He asks. There's no letter for you, but maybe there's some news of her?
Thank you.
Here's the Vivaldi Project and more photography by Craig Nyquist with the Allegrino and Tempo di Minuetto from the Sonata in G Major B37 by Johann Christian Bach, lived from 1735 to 1782. He was one of the many sons of Johann Sebastian Bach, the much better known, to especially to the general public, composer. Thank you so much to Craig for his photos and to Allison Nyquist to learn new editing skills to add his photos to the music. You know, it's amazing how many new skills musicians have developed during the pandemic shutdown. I never thought I would have become a whiz at video editing myself. I hope you like Schubert, because two more Schubert song arrangements are next. First, number 14 in this journey, Der Greise Kopf, probably mispronounced again, or The Gray Head. Frost has turned his, that's our young protagonist who fell in love and was jilted, has turned his hair gray, and he rejoices in being an old man. But when it thaws, he's horrified to be a youth again. How far it is still to the grave, he says. And De Krahe, again, mispronounced probably, or the crow. A crow has been following him. It has never left him, expecting to take his body as the prey. It won't be much longer now. Crow, show me constancy unto death.
Thank you. The title of The Crow, that last song, absolutely, absolutely positive. It does not have me thinking of a certain movie trailer within a hit comedy series. Absolutely, absolutely not. Well, maybe a little. Meanwhile, many people don't know that except for the improvisatory preludes, the movements of Bach cello suites are actually based on dances. So now here's the Vivaldi Project's cellist, wonderful Stephanie Vial, playing the Sarabande, or fourth movement from, let me think that's right, yep, fourth movement, from Bach's G major cello suite with Paige Whitley-Bauguess dancing a Sarabande as it would have been danced back in the 18th century or earlier. You know, that was just another wonderful example of COVID creativity, as I like to call it. These two artists performing in their homes and then combined by video. We're going to have quite a spectacular example of COVID creativity at the end of our show, featuring 10 dancers on the streets of New York City. But that will come after our final two Schubert songs tonight. And before that, let me mention that if you would like to join the family of donors who make these programs possible, you can do so by going to donate.gvmf.live, where you can make a secure donation via PayPal. And now, our last two Schubert songs. Letzte Hoffnung, mispronounced again, I'm sure, Last Hope. He, our protagonist, gambles on a leaf quivering in the wind. If it falls from the tree, all his hopes are dashed. He falls to the ground himself and weeps over the grave of his hopes. And then im Dorf, or in the village, dogs bark, and all the people are asleep, dreaming of successive failure, finding on their pillows what eluded them in life. I am done with dreaming. Why should I linger among the sleepers? Thank you. Well, there are still seven more songs in this wonderful Winter Journey Schubert cycle. We're going to hear them in an upcoming concert or concerts. While spring seems to be springing around us already, you never know. Especially here in Indiana, we could have another snowstorm or two before we get to summer. We're going to finish tonight by sharing with you a really high-budget video produced by the American Dance Machine for the 21st Century. This is Cool from West Side Story with music by Leonard Bernstein, performed by 10 extraordinary dancers all over New York City. It's directed by Tony Award nominee Joshua Bergasse, with choreography, the original choreography by Jerome Robbins, recreated by Robert LaFosse. The dancers and production crew are all credited at the end of the video. Now, I want you to know that ADM21, as the organization is known, is one of the leading centers, maybe the leading center, for musical theater dance, perpetuating the excellence of this genre through preservation, presentation, and education of classic and current notable works of musical theater choreography. If you'd like to support their work and this particular example of COVID creativity, you can go to cool.gvmflive. That will forward to their site. 20% of any donation you make there will be shared equally with the Actors Fund and the Black Theater Coalition. So, enjoy.
Just play it cool, boy. Real cool. Easy action. Cool, baby John.
Wow, wasn't that fantastic? Hey, it was great having you with us. If you are watching on Wednesday evening, join our discussion at gvmf.live. And if not, we will see you next time.